Hey.
Hey, you alright?
Yeah, it's alright. Just carry on.
You sure?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, fine.
Yeah. It's not self-adoration or anything. It's alright. I am vain, but not that vain. Hi guys, welcome back, welcome to Vlog 7. Far too nice to spend any time in this office today, so let's head out. Well, we've arrived at my chosen destination for Vlog 7, and as you can see, backing onto a major A road there. That's the A46, and it's actually a service station, so you can pull in just the side of the service station entry and arrive at this place. So what is this place? This place is Wild's Coppice. Stunning, absolutely stunning. And I really do wish you could smell the perfume. It's almost sickly, it's that intense from all these stunning bluebells. This is the native British bluebell. Not the Spanish invaders that I'm sure you've read about in the press, which is ironic in itself, isn't it? Because it's this time of the year that we tend to invade Spain with our culture. Heading back to my equipment, I hope that no one's stolen it. Not that I'm casting aspersions on Coventry folk, but no need for these, I guess, and probably best to see what I'm doing. So I'll stick these on. I'm just taking in the bird song right now. I hope you can hear it despite that A road audio. Beautiful song thrush. Keeps on repeating phrase. Dee-doo, dee-doo. Keeps on repeating phrases just to my left. Easy way to remember song thrush. The only British bird that will sing a sequence of notes and then repeat them two or three times and then change. So a new sequence of notes, but then repeated two or three times. Wonderful, beautiful spot. Right, let's crack on. Welcome to Vlog 7 officially. We're here in Wild's Coppice. This is a fantastic place, just to the, let me think about this now, just to the west of Brandon Marsh. There's a huge deciduous woodland just here, an ancient one, which I plan to explore. In fact, today is pretty much a recce for that. I plan to explore sometime the next few weeks for a film. And also, what a floral display. Just simply amazing, blows my mind, really does. We're at the height of spring now, guys. It really is kicking in. The season is with us, and my word, don't I know it, I've had an incredibly busy week. Hang about, let's just see if I can grab this little fella and stick him in front of the lens. It's just now hanging next to me, and if you can see this little guy, I'm sure he's not in focus. But that is fantastic to have caught that live whilst I'm doing the vlog. It's a little caterpillar and it's hanging by a very fine silk thread. This isn't a levitation act, there's no magic going on here. And I'll stick him back on his branch in a second, but you see this little guy, obviously I'll put him against my black t-shirt and you can see him there. Awesome. Well, that's the caterpillar of the winter moth. Let me put him back again. Stick him on a branch just there. There he goes. Why is that an amazing caterpillar? Well, that all pertains to one family of birds we have here in Britain called the tit family. More so, I think, the smaller of the tit family. And it's still an element of mystery to this, I believe, to the science on this. But it's been shown that the smaller birds, so the blue tits, the coal tits, up to the size of the great tits, I suppose. It's just still hanging there on a branch. They will time the laying of their eggs and the brooding of their clutch to the proliferance of these caterpillars. So when the eggs hatch, when that clutch hatches, these are in abundance. These particular winter moth caterpillars are hanging everywhere. They provide the main food source for which the parent birds will feed their chicks. I'm going to put my DLL cap on now. What's that? What is this? and the DLL cap refers to the Dunsmore Living Landscape project, and I've been as busy as hell over the last week providing them a film. The deadline was Friday for their launch, which was this last Saturday. Dunsmore Living Landscape, well, that's an area, a project area, just to the southeast of Coventry. It includes many, many great things to see, many points of interest. It also includes a place called Coombe Abbey, and if you ask anybody in Coventry, 99% of them say, oh, we visited Coombe Abbey. But the thing is, the other areas of interest, those incredible areas to visit around the Dunsmore Living Landscape project area, people haven't visited, and that's just because they simply don't know about them. And so the project was born to try and promote the whole project area, and not just for people to go to Coombe Abbey, fantastic place, great historical interest. It's where the conspirators with Guy Fawkes went to hear if Parliament had blown up and the King was dead. So not denying its fantastic value, Coombe Abbey, but also then to promote the amazing other places within the Dunsmore Living Landscape project. Film was produced for Friday, launched on Saturday. Film includes Thomas. He's been dusted down again almost a calendar year since the cottage. In fact, it was the cottage that the head of the project, Chris Redstall, saw and decided that would make a great theme to have this young kid coming through the various points of interest in the landscape, showing people that isn't just Coombe here, there's lots of other things to see and do. That in mind, had the finished spec probably no more than 2 and a bit weeks ago. Desperately needed some sunshine. I was really trying to go for that darling buds of May feel. Perpetual sunshine, etc., etc., and that really wasn't going to happen until the start of this week just gone, bearing in mind the deadline was going to be Friday, and so we really had to be about it. I thought this was the ideal opportunity to provide Thomas with a good work ethic. This is going to be quite an intensive period of shooting of which he was going to be involved, and so we decided that he would have a salary, he would be paid for this job, and rightly so. And also it tells him, it instills in him good work ethic. He was very precise though, very specific about how he wanted to be paid and what he wanted to be paid with.
Super Colossus Tyrannosaurus Rex from Jurassic World.
And let's open this thing up. Oh, there it is. Oh my god. Da-da-da-da. Oh my god, that's so big.
But without further ado, let's watch the film, and when we come back, I'll explain a little bit more about it. Boy is a star, an absolute star. One thing to note though about that film, every single shot in that film was filmed using the same camera. Now, if you've seen the aerial footage there, then you'll must assume, and you'd be right to assume, that this camera was on a drone. I've sold my Mavic Pro. I got rid of it. It retained quite a good value, actually, despite being a year old, because I'd heard such rave reviews about the new Mavic Air, the small cousin of the Mavic Pro. And one thing really, really drew me to this drone, and that was the fact that it could film in 1080p at 120 frames a second. That's slow motion, syrupy goodness. Wonderful stuff. Really keen to get my hands on it. And pretty much with what I sold my Mavic Pro for, I was able to afford, only paying a slight bit more, the Mavic Air Fly More Combo. I'll show you what comes with that. First of all, it comes in a very neat bag. Outside of the bag, by the way, there is a charging unit, a multiple battery charging unit, which I haven't brought with me. But it all comes in this very, very neat little bag, lovely tweed effect. Doesn't come with the iPad mini, which incidentally I've just now relented and started to buy Apple to use with DJI products, because over the previous years I've used Android products and they're just so glitchy. No matter what Android product I use with the DJI, glitchiness, real pain in the arse. Read the blogs, saw the vlogs, heard the chat rooms, and they all said, go Apple. So I've got an iPad mini version 2, any lower than that, well, version 1 is not compatible, so version 2 and higher. Got it reconditioned in second hand, and since then it's been an absolute dream. Back to the bag. Lovely tweedy effect bag. It doesn't come with the koala. The koala is a bonus. This is the koala of destiny, thanks to Grant and Colette from The Simple Joys. He will be with me forever. So open up the bag, and there we have the drone inside. I'm not going to bang on about how small it is. You've seen plenty of videos telling you just how small this little guy is. But in the Fly More Combo, you get a battery on the drone, and then you get two more of these intelligent flight batteries just tucked away inside here. Obviously inside as well, we've got the controller, and the difference to the Mavic Pro is that this controller doesn't have an LCD screen. I didn't use that much anyway. I mean, pretty much if you've got a tablet or a monitor attached to your drone, you're not going to use the little LCD screen. One thing to note, they have given the little toggles a place, a home, and they're now screw-on. So you'll just see that it's tucked away there in the corner, just down here, and then one then on the other side. These two elements for the controls then are threaded. Simply thread on your toggles, and away you go. As always with DJI, lovely solid feel to everything, very well made. But the point being, and the point I'm talking about this Mavic Air now, post watching that DLL film, is that other than the aerial shots, which you've seen, and obviously this is a drone, so it's able to do that, it was handheld gimbal time. And these drones, and whether this drone, whether it's the Mavic or whether it's the Phantom you've got, make fantastic handheld gimbals. That, together with the 120 frames a second in HD, produced incredible results. Everyone was raving about it. So, so pleased. So if I can promote anything today on this vlog, is take your drone out sometimes and don't fly it. Try using it as a handheld gimbal. Boost everything up, but don't take off. Just film as you walk around. Sometimes it's better if you do a bit of what we call the gimbal walk. It's a bit like a Monty Python. You've got to roll kind of heel to toe, but you'll perfect that over time. Do not ignore the huge value that these drones provide you by using them as a handheld gimbal. Absolutely stunning results. So, so happy with this particular purchase. Congratulations to Grant, AD Quinn, and the Urban Gardener for getting last vlog's teaser right. Absolutely. Steve Austin, the $6 million man, the Bionic Man, so many monikers for this guy. Wonderful series, really, really lit up our lives as kids. Let's go and have a quick look.
Colonel Steve Austin, the $6 million man, and the new Bionic Transport and Repair Station.
Look, it's crashing! We'll put him in the Bionic Repair Station. We can rebuild him. We'll replace the modules in the Bionic arm.
No injury here.
We'll have to check his eye.
Bionic Eye, A-OK. $6 million man, ready for action.
New Bionic Transport and Repair Station sold separately. The $6 million man, new from Kenner.
This week's vlog teaser is going to involve a short ride, so back to the car in a few seconds. All will be explained, or maybe not, depending how you see it, when we get there. But before we head off, I'm going to use my drone to do a bit of B-roll, using it as a handheld gimbal. This is a no-fly zone here anyway. We're so close to Coventry Airport, which is just in that direction. And also there's a huge National Grid line coming right through the heart of this place. So in its own, this is the perfect time to use the drone as a handheld gimbal. And you should be seeing the footage from that right now. So today's teaser is going to be here, based in the suburbs of Coventry. It's Bindley Woods, on the outskirts of Coventry, and it relates to this house behind me here. You can just see it there. This is 117 Heather Road, and it's a particularly special house, especially if you're a Gen X kid, grew up in the 80s or 90s, because the resident of this house behind me was very famous. And so if you can tell me what this house relates to, and who might have lived in this house, not only this house, but if I move next door, the next door neighbours were very much part of the whole setup for this. And that's this tan coloured house here. The two houses combined were particularly iconic for people who watched a lot of TV. I don't know what else, what are the clues to try and give to you for the teaser, but if you can think of what this house you've just seen and this house now here behind me relate to, then please leave your answers in the comments below. I'm wondering if anybody will get it. I'm wondering if anybody from the States might get it, or Australia. One other clue, this particular street and this particular piece of the pavement here would often have a postman fearing for his life as he approached this house that we've just seen. So if you have any ideas, I know it's very cryptic, but if you have any ideas, please leave your answers in the comments below. And of course, I'll allude to the correct answer in vlog 8. Please, please, please subscribe to the channel. Please hit the bell for instant alerts for anything I upload to this channel. And please do give me the big thumbs up. Thanks, guys. Missing you already. See you in vlog 8. Cheerio.